Hello, to all CAT 2021 aspirants. CAT notification has been released. It's time to gear up for your final phase of CAT prep. Let's get started with going through the media release and what are the key points to keep in mind. First thing first, guys, the dates are important. Registration for the exam opens on 4th August and closes on 15th September. So now, do not delay it too much. Ideally, it's good that you book your slots in the first 2-3 weeks. So I would suggest that maybe by this weekend or the next weekend, try to go through the website and check out the form, and in another 1-2 weeks, you can fill it up and close it. It's not a very complicated thing. Right. So, important thing here is that in terms of cities, be very careful. Don't fill random cities just because you're given options. At times, it happens that you don't get the city of your preference. So, first preference, second preference, third preference, be very serious about it. Usually, we try to fill the city which we live in and then the nearest cities that we have access to. In these COVID times, it's more and more important that you are very careful in the cities that you want to fill. Okay. All right. And of course, mentioning COVID here, remember to take care of your health and be safe. Wear mask. Do not go out if it's not necessary and maintain social distance. Because guys, CAT is an exam where regular aptitude practice gets you through the line. But you need to be well for that, right? So the most important challenge you have is to be safe. If you are safe, you keep attending classes, you keep practicing tests, it's not a big deal, right? So many students every year from our classes, they go to IIMs. The biggest virtue that they have is discipline, right? So that added discipline thing that you need to put apart from consistent studies is you have to put in conscious effort to stay safe. Right. So please do that. Okay. Moving forward, in the form, as mentioned, you have to put a photograph, give a signature and the city preference. In terms of photograph, do not put a very old photo. Ideally, try to put a month or 2 or 3 month older photo, not more than that, or a latest photo. Reason being that it's for photo validation, and it shouldn't happen that you look totally different on the exam day and totally different in the form. So keep that in mind, right? Okay. Now, important thing, the notification says that the exam is on 28th November, right? And it's a 120 minute exam. So a lot of things that I'll talk about today is we'll take insights from the last year paper. There will be 3 sections. VA, DILR, and the QA, verbal and reading comprehension, data interpretation and logical reasoning, and the quantitative ability section. Nothing changes there. Each section is for 40 minutes, right? So you cannot switch from one section to the other, right? You have to give 40 minutes to each of the sections. CAT does release tutorials before the exam, so you will be going through that, all right? Also, you should now each of your mock tests from now onwards will be of 2 hours, so you should take those seriously, and you will get a good habit of tackling these papers. In some of the mocks going forward, still will not give the same pattern as the last year in terms of number of questions, because that is something CAT often changes. Number two, when IIM Ahmedabad conducts CATs, you can always expect some or the other kind of change, right? That is an insight word that I would like to put from my side. Okay. These things being talked, let me take you to this internal refactory file. It talks about CAT 2020 mostly. And also there are some things, information announcements and generic tips to keep in mind. So step by step, CAT 2020 had 3 sections. I'll keep coloring it as we move. The 3 sections were verbal, DILR, and quantitative. Okay. Verbal and quantitative had 26 questions each, while DILR had 24 questions. Time was again 40 minutes each. Okay. All right. So, and marking scheme was plus 3, minus 1. And plus 3, 0 for TETA questions. Type in the answer type questions, very non-MCQ questions. So, out of these 76 questions, last year, I think around 18 or 20, maybe 19 questions were from TETA. So, 5 to 8 questions in every section, maybe 5 in DILR, 8 in QA. 5 to 8 questions in every section are type in the answer types. Out of these, 26 questions. Alright? Okay. So, total marks, if you see, 228 marks. Right? Okay. Now, let's look at the breakup in terms of what came last year. More or less, it will remain similar. Alright? RC, 18 questions. And verbal reasoning, 8 questions. 3 PJ, 3 PS, and 2 odd one out. So this can go plus minus 1 or 2 there. But para-jumbles, para-summary, odd one out, and para-completion. These are essentially the 4 most important topics in CAT verbal reasoning. And RC, of course. You can expect some changes might happen, but mostly 3 to 4 RCs with 3 to 6 questions each. A total of 18 questions. That is what the pattern was, right? Okay. DILR was mixed. It was a mixed bag. 3 DI and 2 LR is what we saw the previous year. And the number of questions varied from 4 to 6. Okay. You can see that over here, right? Okay. All right. Quantitative last year, algebra had a little more weightage in terms of percentage compared to the previous years. So there were still 9 to 10 questions in arithmetic, which was the, which normally is the majority section in CAT. QA. But 7-8 questions from algebra, 5-6 from geometry. Overall, guys, anyways, remember, these three modules, they have the most topics in CAT QA. Most highest weightage. Arithmetic may time, speed, distance, time and work, then commercial maths, profit loss percentage, ratios, then solution, average, allegation. These are the topics which are important. Algebra, quadratic equation, linear equation, inequality, maxima, minima, a bit of functions, and logarithm, right? So these are important. In geometry, circles, triangles, area mensuration, area and volume, these are important topics. And then what they call modern maths, number system and permutation combination probability, these are, this is another short module, right? So mostly algebra, geometry and arithmetic, these three are the most important three modules in CAT QA. Now this is something which is quite generic. It happens, it's been happening over years, so you can keep that in mind, okay? All right. Now, out of this 228 marks, see, typically, now, I started preparing for CAT in 2006, so when I was a fresher. So typically, since then, I have seen that a 40% marks is considered good in CAT, okay? And 60% marks is super, all right? That is the kind of experience that in general over so many years, if I have to put it. So if you want to get maybe a half a dozen IIM calls, you don't want to get that, you want to get all, right? But what I'm saying is, in general, a score like 90 will give you some IIM calls, and a score of 130 will give you maybe all IIM calls if you have sections balanced, right? So 90 to 30, if I have to put that in terms of number of questions, if assuming nothing goes wrong, that's kind of too hypothetical, but then 30 to 43 questions out of 76, right? Okay, so out of 76 questions, that is the range to get IIM calls, more or less, right? Last year, the sectional cutoffs were between 21 to 30, mostly. You can see all that here, right? Okay. Now, guys, important thing here is, see, if you get a 30-30-30 in all the three sections, you will get some IIM calls, right? But typically, maybe there is a section where you're not that strong. Even if you get a 24 there, don't get disheartened. You can always get a 45 in some other section and make up and get IIM calls, right? Last year, more or less for the general category, IIM calls, the kind of score required to just get the first IIM call was close to 70 to 75. To get new IIM calls started, right, it was 85 to 90. And all IIM calls, the older ones, blackie, to get that started, it was close to 100. So this is to give you a tentative idea. See, point is, nobody can say that the level of difficulty of the exam will be same like the last year. But more or less, plus minus 5-10 marks here and there, this is the kind of range that you are looking at. Okay. If you want to get all IM calls, all right, you should be 120 plus. 100 plus will give you most of the IM calls. Okay. And 80 plus will give you some IM calls. Mota moti, keep that in mind. Okay. You must have understood by now that then selection is very important, right? Because what's a 90 marks? 90 marks is 30 questions out of 76 questions. If you're selective and if you're accurate, right? So these were some generic remarks. You take tests, focus very, very hard on these two aspects. Very, very hard. When I say very hard means try to make sure that you don't mark if you're not sure. Try to make sure that if you are going to leave a question, leave it fast. These two things will make you a better skilled candidate at taking the exam. So keep that in mind. Okay. Apart from that, some announcements. Let me make that and then I'll come to the generic tips once again. So now that the announcement is made for the exam, we are having our replica CAT, last year replica paper, 2-hour paper, which will be based on the last year pattern as well and the level as well. It starts on 16th August. Every BFACT student must take this test. Why I say must? There are the mock CATs keep happening, but why this one is a must? Because based on your performance, there will be customized sessions where we'll discuss strategy with you. Okay? While you're taking this test, be selective, be accurate. Definitely take this test. Right, so these notifications will again come on your batch groups, but keep this in mind. Right, 16th to 25th August is the window when you have to take the CAT 20 replica test at BFactory, and the end of this month, 26th to 31st August, is the time when we'll be having custom strategy sessions on how to go about your preparation. So then the tips become more specific. All right, but let me give you some generic tips here, some additional ones. One very important thing, speed read and keep the objective of reading in mind. Read every day, half an hour to 1 hour as required. You feel the need for it. Read philosophy, psychology, sociology, economics, newspaper, editorials, right? When you are reading, read fast, read a paragraph fast and identify the theme. This is the key. I keep saying that over and over again because that is what makes you fast. When you are trying to read LR, try to read fast. A maths problem, some try to read fast, but keep the objective in mind. Objective-oriented reading is very important. Understand this, okay? You will hear so many things going around when you prepare for CAT, right? Try to focus on some important things, like objective-based reading. You should not get lost while you're reading a question, right? You should be on your toes and try to focus to make sense of the given data or information as soon as fast while you're reading, right? Keep these things in mind. So effective reading is very important. So every time you read, never make it a casual reading. Try to read with as effective in a manner that is possible. QADILR, revision is very, very important. Whatever you have studied, you know, BFactory sheets, BFactory books, apps, mock tests, previous year CAT papers, whatever, keep revising. It should happen in a round robin fashion. In quants, one question solved today should again be solved after maybe 20, 30 days. So every sheet should keep going one over the other, and that's the cycle should keep repeating. Because in the exam, even the difficult questions that you have solved in class will become easy when they come in the exam. Got it? In DILR, noticing and focusing on process memory is very important. What I mean is, suppose there is an LR set, okay? And there is a missing data. You fill in that data and there is another step, you do some calculation and then all the questions get solved. So quite often, you have to first make sense of the given data, then maybe generate some equations and then solve it, right? Or maybe get a second level data generated and then solve it. Try to remember the process for the type of data set. It's not just about solving, it's about remembering the process. Got it? Post the test, this test and the discussion that we'll have, you could, if required, for DILR, maybe even talk to Najesh sir or Kamesh sir, and get deeper insights on how to build process memory in DILR. All right. Okay. Also, during mocks, when you are done with the mocks, do an analysis, try to get your doubts cleared, seek improvement, right, from one mock to the other. If you're getting one question wrong, revise it time and again. If you're losing accuracy somewhere, try to identify and correct it from one mock to the other. All right. if you find that one topic is hurting you, maybe focus a lot more on that for 2-3 days and try to gain confidence. So step on step, seek improvement. Remember, guys, see, CAT is an aptitude exam, all right? And year on year, we have sent students to all the top B schools in the country. We have identified a pattern. The pattern that is that remains constant for years. That pattern, it involves two most important things. Number one, discipline. You cannot crack an exam like CAT by studying for 10 hours a day and then not studying for 5 days. It's not like that. You have to keep attending the classes. You have to keep taking the tests. You have to keep revising. That focus, and you have to keep reading. That focus and discipline has to remain over a period of long time. Okay. Point number two. So this was the first point, right? Stay disciplined. Point number two, never give up. Your mock scores might not reflect how much you will do on CAT. Okay. Your class performance might not reflect how much you will get in CAT. It's an aptitude exam. Okay. A lot depends on your raw intellect and your ability, your confidence to tackle questions. Focus more than your marks, more than the time you spend, focus on how you tackle the paper. What I mentioned, no? Accuracy, leaving questions, that is selection, speed while reading, approach, focus is what makes you crack CAT. Keep that in mind. Okay. Hard work is important. Smart work is more important. Okay. If you keep that in mind, right, it's not a very difficult exam and there's lots of time left. Not for a moment feel that there's anything to take pressure once the announcement has come. No, nothing like that. Every day, start your day with a smile, end it with a laughter. Believe that today you have learned something, tomorrow you will learn more, and every day you are becoming a sharper and a better candidate for CAT. With every passing mock CAT, believe that I'll raise my score by 5 marks, by 10 marks, by 2 marks. Every time seek improvement. Do not feel at any point of time that there is anything that can go wrong. Believe in yourself, stay put. That is the mantra to crack the exam. All right, all the best, and let's gear up. Thank you.